Stanley.
Stanley F. Music Hall, swinging Stan the Man. He's the man that thrills the band, swinging Stan the Man.
Here's the pitch. Line drive, that is! Into left field! Hit number 3,000! A run is scored! Music Hall around first! On his way to second!
Life here in St. Louis stopped for a couple hours yesterday to celebrate the life and baseball career of the Cardinals' greatest player. Stanley Frank Musial died a week ago yesterday at age 92. Fox 2's Charlie Marlowe takes one final look back at Stan the Man's legacy through the eyes of some of the greatest players in Cardinals history.
Up next, number 6, Stanley Musial. And God looked down upon him and smiled.
On Saturday, Stan Musial was laid to rest. The day was a fitting tribute to the man who was the face of the St. Louis Cardinals for more than 70 years. By now, you know all the stats. Musial's numbers on the baseball field put him into the Hall of Fame. But it was the way Stan carried himself off the field for 92 years that made number 6 so special to so many.
Somebody kind of rub him a little wrong, and he'd say, "Now be nice, be nice." He never did ever say anything wrong. He was just, it was like sunshine with being around him all the time.
Stan was the man when you talked about Cardinal baseball, and such a generous man, very kind. And I've been telling people that the nicest thing that somebody could probably say about you is that I've never heard a bad word said about you. And he was just one of those people, man, that was very approachable. He was a guy who was very sensitive to people.
Each player ought to commit with his passing that they're going to never forget it and represent the Cardinal tradition off the field like Stan would have.
This was a celebration. You know, there was some lumps and throats in there, but it was a pure celebration of a wonderful life.
Baseball really was a great game, and baseball is really a great game. And baseball will always be a great game.
Stan Musial represented and personified this standard of excellence for the Cardinals for almost 70 years, and always with a grace and style and a touch of humor, playing the harmonica, which endeared him to everyone.
A stranger approached me on Thursday during Stan's public viewing. Tears running down his eyes, he said to me, "Your grandpa's best attribute was that he made nobodies feel like they were somebodies." After all the accolades he received in his long career, his kindness to strangers, day in and day out, for over 92 years, is a part of his legacy that is most enduring.
So many great stories told by members of Musial's family at the funeral service, and then the highlight was a 19-minute and 13-second eloquent eulogy by Bob Costas. Here Costas talks about a conversation he had with Mickey Mantle about Stan the Man.
He said, "You know, I had as much ability as Stan, maybe more. Nobody had more power than me. Nobody could run any faster than me. But Stan was a better player than me because he's a better man than me. Because he got everything out of his life and out of his ability that he could. And he'll never have to live with all the regret that I live with." Some of you here may remember Stan Musial's last at-bat, part of a 2-for-3 afternoon in 1963 against the Cincinnati Reds, a single to right field. Others may have heard the radio call of Harry Carey that day. And as Stan settled into the box, Harry said, "Take a look, fans. Take a good long look."
Remember the stance and the swing. The pitch to Musial. A hot shot on the ground into right field, a base hit. This ball around third. Here's a no throw. The Cardinals lead 1-0. Listen to the crowd.
We won't see his like again. Harry was right. We never have, and we never will.
Honoring the greatest Cardinal of them all, Stan the Man Musial. Charlie Marlowe, Fox 2 Sports.